So currently we are under 12 weeks out now, officially. This will probably come out around 11 and a half weeks out. So currently we just came off the tail end of a week-long refeed. Last night we ended it off with a burger and fries, a little bit. So the whole last week was about 700 grams of carbs each day. And we roughly lost about a pound and a half throughout that week itself. So kind of pulled back on training as well throughout that week. Did a de-volume week, so it was just one set per exercise. Easy peasy, a little bit of warm-up sets here and there just for compound movements, just to make sure you're fucked up. Other than that, now we get back into the deep end of prep. Carbs are still relatively high, around 550, 480-ish on training days, and then rest days a little bit lower than that. Nothing too crazy, but today we got lats, chest, and arms. So essentially with that, we have two chest movements, two back movements, and the rest is just arms. And even with that, we just have two sets per exercise. So it's very simple workout in itself, but we got the job done. So we'll crack on from there. So for here, we're just gonna do two little warm-up sets just to prime everything. Make sure the bench is in a good spot and the bar path falls in a good line. And we'll jump into our top sets. Just got one top set, one back off set for this, if I'm correct. Training stays all the exact same throughout the remainder of prep. In all reality, I've only had two training programs in the last 2.5, 3 years. So at least that way we can just make sure we really maximize each exercise. Of course, if you top out on an exercise, you swap something else in, just to keep things flowing quite good. But other than that, the basics. A little push movement, stretch movement for chest. That's it, that's all. So we'll get on with it. So like I said, two little easy warm-up sets just to make sure things are flowing nicely. Variation. I find that incline pec deck, which is nice, has a good contraction. It's just too light, as cocky as that might sound. Just the strength curve on it is too easy. So going from here as opposed to that pec deck or the other one, like I have to put an extra 45 pound plate on that one. I just don't think the strength, like the curve on it, is not right. So at least this is brutally fucking honest with you. So I really can't max this up, which is nice. So I prefer this, but it is nice to use a pec deck. It's just the ones that they have here, they're just not it. So do a little bit of a decline fly instead. Again, we'll just do one little warm-up set just to acquaint myself with the exercise, and we dive in. I got three sets here. So 8 to 10, 10 to 12, then 15 to 20. Man, as bad as it sounds, I had knee surgery on this knee. Just play varsity football and travel football and whatnot for the city. And got hit by a big farm boy. Took my fucking knee with him on the tackle. Tore my ACL, MCL, ripped out the cartilage from the knee in itself. So I played one more season with a big brace. And I was just a target on the field. So during the whole process of, you know, post-surgery rehab and whatnot, it was really just the exercise portion of getting myself back into the groove of things. And being an athlete, I never wanted to stop competing.
Yeah.
But playing football, in my opinion, just wasn't worth it at the end of the day. I didn't want to be 45 and fucking crippled or concussed multiple times. I already was concussed a few times. So I figured in the gym, I'm the only one that could hurt myself. So I'd take that upon myself if that were to ever be the case. Which it has been here and there, nothing crazy. But I just always had the athlete in me that just didn't want to stop competing. So stuck with the gym.
Yeah.
As shitty as it was, but football was fun, but I'd rather walk. Chest movements done. You got one unilateral row for back, and that's it. So two chests, one back, the rest triceps, biceps. And yeah, man. So I'm gonna use this chest supported row, single arm, so it won't be my chest on there, it'll be the hand in itself. And we'll dip right at it. But nothing crazy. Two sets again. And that's all we need. So I'll run you down. Biggest thing, these things are important when it comes time to prep especially. But, so I have everything labeled out. This is an old one, this is today. So this dates back to 16 weeks out, 14 and a half weeks out, 12 and a half, and then today, pretty much 11. So, biggest thing here, the biggest takeaway, is being able to track your strength throughout the entirety of prep in itself. So, for example, the last push, or the last lats chest arm day, I feel like a fan ran a marathon. The last session we had for this exact workout, we can look back and see for the first set we had 295 for the JP Smith for 10. We go back to today, we had 295 for 12. Same thing for the exercise we just did for the pull movement. 5 plates plus a 35 for 9. Today we got 5 plates plus a 35 for 10. So this really just helps to see where you're at throughout the entirety of your prep. Obviously strength will come down ever so slightly near the tail end of prep, but it shouldn't be a detrimental factor from the first 2/3 of your prep in itself. So being able to track it like that is a very simple way to make sure that A, tissue is sticking and you're not losing muscle mass as well, to make sure you keep yourself in fucking check with your overall performance and execution within the sets in itself. So that ghetto ass little logbook is what helps keep me on track, making sure that A, I'm not being a bitch in the gym, and B, making sure that I keep as much muscle tissue as possible throughout the remainder of prep. So
That's why we use them. So the reason why I don't use an app on my phone, like you'll see, I haven't pulled out my phone since we stepped on that treadmill. It's just a distraction. Anybody that ever trains with me will never see me use my fucking phone, no matter what. Unless it's my wife calling me and she's saying she's in trouble or whatever. She's the only one, as well as one other guy, Blake, that can get to me while it's on Do Not Disturb. And that's only for emergency purposes. But if I pull my phone out, I'm checking client messages, Instagram things pop up. It's just fucking, it's just nonsense.
Yeah.
So it's even why I don't listen to music when I train, is I found I was just getting lost in the music in itself.
Yeah.
I was moving weight from point A to point B meaninglessly. I wasn't connecting with the exercise in itself. So no music, no phone. I got this trash 80s music. That's about it, man. Keep it as plain as simple.
That's crazy. I need music.
See, I thought I did too. But I was just getting so lost in it, you know? You need that big break if you're doing like a deadlift or compound. But when I was just training, it was just boom, 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 boom.
Yeah.
I wasn't squeezing. I wasn't focusing really. It was just DMX in my headphones.
Yeah.
Going off at me. That's really it. So the less distractions, the better. 3 years? 2.5 years?
Yeah, okay.
Ever since I finished my last show, I started with my new coach, Kuba. It wasn't his decision to do that to me, to take the headphones away. I know he uses headphones, but personally, I have a little bit of ADHD. So like, shit like that, it's just a distraction. Tissue that you're actually working. Reason being, you train, you get a good pump, great. But you have to open up the fascia and the tissue itself just to allow that blood flow to continue to carry on. Do that just simply between your sets. I don't stretch post-workout. Some people might get offended by that. I don't give a shit. Do it between your sets while you're doing nothing. Open up the tissue, allow better blood flow, more pump will occur. Now, mind you, the pump is not what we're chasing. We're chasing overall progression within the exercise in itself and execution. The pump will come along. But stretch between your sets. Give it a go, and you'll see a nice shift in your overall performance. Don't do it close to the same thing, one little acquaintance set, if you will. Yourself in the movement, stuck in a little bit. Especially for these accessory things, you don't need multiple warm-up sets. It's just a waste of time.
off we go to the last exercise.
Guys, here is the single arm high curl. And pretty much just doing two sets with a rest pause set at the end. So it'll be quick, easy. This whole workout in itself maybe took hour or so.
Yeah.
Not long at all. Plus breaks and talking to the camera. So maybe 50 minutes, 45 minutes to be honest with you. And it just goes to show you don't have to live in the gym. You know, get in, get fucking out. Just be productive with your time. And you'll do just fine. At the current moment, none of my workouts take longer than an hour and 10 minutes. So there's no reason to be doing crazy amount of warm-up sets, working sets in total. I definitely wasn't. I've worked with coaches in the past where, I kid you not, the workout itself with just weights would be like 3 hours. And I look like a bag of shit. It was just bad. I mean, it really comes down to finding out what you can recover from and executing everything within that optimally. If you find that recovery / performance circle, you're good, man. 45 minutes, 60 minutes, that's all you really need. Get in, get out, and just be effective, you know? Keep on track with what you gotta do, and you'll be good. So, like I said, with this, we just got two normal sets, then a rest pause set at the very end, and we're done. My training is basic as hell. We do 2 days on, 1 day off, 2 days on, 1 day off, so on and so forth. And over the span of my whole training career, I've done all sorts of shit. But I've found the less time I'm in the gym, as odd as it may sound, the better I get. Whereas opposed to before, I was maybe doing 5-6 training sessions a week. Now with that two on, one off, two on, one off, kind of averages out to 4 days 1 week, 5 days the next week. So 3 rest days, 2 rest days, so on. And that's really worked well for me in terms of just progression as making sure my recovery's optimized. You know, you really have to tick off all the boxes. And if you're not recovering from your training, dieting, so on, you're not gonna progress. So 4 to 5 times a week in the gym is best for me personally. If it's not that for you, so be it. You gotta find what works for you and kick with it. But between 4 to 5 sessions per week, like I said, an hour tops. Obviously when cardio gets implemented, that might change. But we normally split up our cardio away from the training itself, just because my schedule allows for it. But yeah, 4 to 5 sessions per week is pretty much all I ever do.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's worked very well for me in the last 2 years. I think we put on about, last show I was about 168. And we're 211 now with close to conditioning. So by the time we hit stage, it should be about 30 pounds of tissue in the last 2.5 years.
Damn.
Yeah. So it should be fun. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
Not expecting anything. We just show up the best that we can and let the judges take it from there. But we shall see. That's the Legends Cup. And then from there, qualify for Nationals the weekend after that. See how we do. That's what we'll go for the pro card, hopefully. I have no expectations of putting a lot of pressure on myself. This has been the most relaxed prep I've had ever. Stress is at a minimal. And that's just because I'm just focusing on the daily tasks. I'm not focusing on, I'm gonna win my pro card. Fuck all that nonsense. You know, you show up and do your thing in the gym and if you are warranted that pro card, because A, you put the work in and effort in and you look the part and your character shows on stage, you'll get it. If somebody else takes it and they rightfully deserve it, you better just clap for them, shake their hand and call it a day. You know, it just wasn't your time. And I've been in that position the last two times I went to Nashville, it came second in my class every time. So I'm humble enough to know that if somebody beats me, they rightfully deserved it, and it just wasn't my day. So we have the two shows here in Canada, and then if need be, we'll do another show a couple weeks after that in the UK. So that'll be one of the reasons why I go to England. So we'll see how that one pans out. If we need to do it, we do it. If not, cool. We still go to England, just vacation for a little bit. And that's October the 22nd, I believe. Forgive me if I'm wrong. It's the third week of October, something like that. So I got three shows lined up, potentially. Two for sure, one possibly in the UK. Yeah, see how she goes.
Sweet.
Yeah, man, it'll be a good time over there, for sure. But we'll get this last set wrapped up with a rest pause. That's it. Episode one is in the books. So probably see us around 11 and a half weeks out. Let's see if I can send Matt some pictures for you guys to see what we kind of look like. We're not gonna pose today or anything. But sitting at 212 now, like I said, post 1 week long of refeeds and off plan burger and fries last night. And like I said, we lost a couple pounds over that week, filled out. Now we dive back down into a deficit ever so slightly. There's still no cardio in play. It's just 12,000 steps a day. And carbs are roughly now about 450 on training days and a little bit less there on rest days. But body's feeling good. We're fresh, ready to go for each session. So next episode that we do film is about 3 weeks time. So about 9.5 weeks out, we'll see another one. But for now, peace out. Be sure to like, follow, subscribe, share, all that shit, and we'll carry on from there. So you guys take it easy.